Chamber's General Meeting. Unless otherwise announced, meetings are held Thursday mornings at 9:30 at the Lorain County Administration Building, 226 Middle Avenue, 4th floor, downtown Elyria. These are public meetings, and as always, you are invited to attend.
Madam Clerk, before we begin this meeting on the 26th of August, I would ask Stan Seneger to meet me at the podium. Animal Control Manager, and he needs to be sworn in. I brought this, oh, so you both see it.
Oh, okay.
Raise your hand, please. In fact, just go ahead and read it.
I, Stanley R. Seneger, do solemnly swear that I will support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of Ohio, and that I will faithfully and impartially discharge and perform all duties of the Office of Animal Control Manager, to which I have been appointed according to the best of my ability and understanding, and this I do, as I shall answer unto God.
Congratulations, Stan.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Morning, Commissioners.
Good morning.
I would like to say just a short thing, if, with your indulgence. I've just sworn an oath to abide by the law, enforce the law of the state of Ohio, and that's what I will do. Anything beyond that, I will attempt to do as time goes by. So I appreciate your faith in me, and I think you will find that we can work well together, and I want to work for you in the best manner I can. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Stan. Okay, Madam Clerk.
Job and Family Services bills.
So moved. Second.
Discussion. Ms. Vacy?
Aye.
Ms. Blair?
Aye.
Mr. Moore?
Aye.
There are no investments today. Appropriations?
So moved.
Second.
Discussion. Mr. Moore?
Aye.
Ms. Blair?
Aye.
Ms. Vacy?
Aye, with the exception of page 7 of 7.
Transfers?
So moved.
Second.
Discussion? Ms. Vacy?
Aye.
Mr. Moore?
Aye.
Ms. Blair?
Aye.
There are no advances or repayments today. Requisitions?
So moved.
Second.
Discussion? Ms. Blair?
Aye.
Mr. Moore?
Aye.
Ms. Vacy?
Aye, with the exception of 1438.
Travel expenses?
So moved.
Second.
Discussion? Mr. Moore?
Aye.
Ms. Blair?
Aye.
Ms. Vacy?
Aye.
Bills?
So moved. Second.
Discussion? Ms. Vacy?
Aye.
Ms. Blair?
Aye.
Mr. Moore?
Aye.
Authorize various personnel actions as indicated on the sheet for employees within the jurisdiction of the Lorain County Board of Commissioners.
Commissioners, there were no actions listed on the summary sheet, but I have a brief matter that I need to discuss, and it's part of an issue of bargaining, and I will request an executive session at the conclusion of the meeting, and it'll be very brief.
Thank you.
Okay. Under Commissioners, number 10, accept proposal from RLS and Associates Incorporated, Dayton, Ohio, to provide an ongoing administration and operations guidance for the Lorain County Transit System in an amount not to exceed $20,000. The primary purpose of this project is to aid the Lorain County Board of Commissioners in addressing complex administrative and operating issues and to provide other technical assistance as needed.
Also moved. Second, but Jim, I have a question. On task number 5, the on-call projects, Do you know what the hourly rate is? It's not to exceed $5,400, but what is the hourly rate?
I don't know, Commissioner. I can obviously clarify that. Some of those tasks there, we're probably not going to use them for. I'm more concerned with getting them on board right now so we can start moving on some of those program issues that they highlighted in their study. I can get you more information if you'd like. I wanted them to give us a flat fee, not to exceed fee, for a particular scope of work so that we didn't have a perpetual billing going on.
But I think we're going to have to know what their hourly rate is.
Okay, I can do that.
And another thing, too, talking about the transit. While I was at the fair on Monday, I heard some complaints that seniors have to pay to go to the fair, and they hadn't done that in the past.
I can't speak to what they've done in the past, but if we have to pay to run the bus, we have to charge. The seniors pay half price for their tickets right now. They have a golden Buckeye card.
I think it was full price. And that person had to pay to get in the fair, which seniors were not paying to get in the fair. So she paid for transit to get there and then transit to get back home, paid for the fair. And these things weren't done in the past, and she was just complaining about it.
Well, with regard to the fair, that's something that's outside our purview.
I understand that, but the transit, another story.
If you pass the information with the lady's name, I'll contact her. But if she is over 60, mm-hmm. and she has I think you have to have a golden Buckeye card to prove your age, because you can't get those until you're 60, and then your fare is half price for the seniors. So, obviously we may be able to do something for her there and correct some of that.
I mean, it doesn't seem like a lot, but to a senior that's on a fixed income and that wants to enjoy themselves at the fair, it just seemed like if we did it in the past, we should continue it.
I
don't know. It's not up to me. I'm not the only one here. It's up to all three of us what we decide to do.
I understand, Commissioner.
Okay. Anyway, that's my beef for today.
Thanks, Commissioner.
Any further discussion?
No.
Ms. Blair?
Aye.
Ms. Facey?
Aye.
Mr. Moore?
Aye.
But I want to put number 5 on hold, if we can.
Oh, absolutely.
Till we find out an hourly rate, because, they can come in here without this and say $1,000 an hour.
I'll get you an hourly rate, but the objectives of task specific, they have to perform that task. But I'll get you an hourly rate for that, Commissioner. No problem. In fact, I'll have a call made this afternoon, and we'll have it before the day's out today.
All right.
Okay, number 11 under Community Development Department. Authorize the submission of a watershed coordinator grant application between the Ohio Department of Natural Resources and the Lorain County Board of Commissioners.
Ron, you want me to hold this map up?
You can hold it up. I left it at your desk so you could share it with the other two commissioners. What we have is an opportunity. About a week and a half ago, we got a call from ODNR asking that since Black River, the entire Black River watershed, was the only one in the U.S. that was an area of concern, and we have made considerable improvements to the water quality of Black River. With the advent of roughly a half of our county now falling under the MPDES Phase 2 permitting requirements for stormwater management and several other things, they have asked, EPA and ODNR have asked, that we apply on behalf of the county for a watershed coordinator's grant that would fund for a 6-year period the watershed position. The first year it is 100% of the salary and fringe benefit for the coordinator, and then for the 5 years following that, it is reduced by their grant by 10%. The county will pick up 10% each year after that. What we're asking today is permission from the Board of County Commissioners to apply for a watershed coordinator grant. The total dollar amount is $192,000 that the ODNR and several other agencies will be putting towards that 6-year commitment to the Black River. The map that I presented to the president is the area of Lorain County that is covered by the Black River, and I'm happy to attempt to answer any questions you might have.
Ron, you said the first year they're giving 100%. Then what happens?
The second year it'll be 10% by us, 90% by this grant. The third year, we will then pick up 20%. Then the fourth year, it'll be 30%. Fifth year, it'll be 40%. And then the sixth and last year of the grant, it will be 50% us and 50% from the grant. We have right now a total of 9 different entities, primarily from Lorain County, but it also includes villages of, like the village of Spencer and Lodi. We received Lodi's support letter already, so we think that while we've only had 10 days to work on this, Commissioner, we think that there's a willingness from some of those organizations to help with the cost of this as well.
So what you're thinking is that the other entities will also be contributing?
Right. And
but we don't know yet?
Yeah, we don't know yet. I can't stand here and tell you that in the 10 days we have that worked out. But, you know, here's $192,000 that will be provided to us to do that through ODNR and EPA and others. We think we can get local match. The total requested at this point from the commissioners over that 6-year period would be $76,000 over the 6 year. It would not require anything during that first year.
Other questions?
What about support staff? How are you going to handle the support staff as coordinator?
At this point, we plan to fill the needs with support staff through our department and through people like OSU Extension, Soil and Water Conservation, the Health District. You know, they're very willing to assist in there.
Okay.
Well, my concern would be once we contribute or agree to contribute, then the other entities really don't have to.
Nope.
I mean, they know that we're paying. Why should they even agree to put anything in there?
I think that issue will probably come up in 6 years when we have to decide whether or not to fund 100%.
I think the second year,
so.
Dave, the
no.
second year.
Oh, we're with a 10% depreciating off every year, that's not a bad cost to get that kind of money and to get something rolling. I mean, the one thing you don't want to be is the only nastiest watershed in the country.
The only area of concern in all of the United States.
Yeah, and doing nothing is something that's unacceptable.
And the reason we were asked to participate in this or apply for this, they only issue 2 of these a year, 2 watershed grants. Typically, they've gone to the larger communities or counties, Cuyahoga County, Hamilton County. But now they see the effort on behalf of the Board of Commissioners. We've been working, doing our own environmental plan as you guys have funded. We've worked with the Army Corps. We've received grants from EPA to work on the Black River. We have that agreement with the Delta Institute. So they're very impressed with the progress that we're making here in Lorain County. So they're asking that we apply for these funds.
Is there a deadline for the application?
September 1st.
Oh. Any further questions?
We should know by October 1st, and none of the funds are going to be committed until after we've been approved by the grant. So it's a 30-day turnaround on their part.
Also move for approval.
No second.
Any further discussion? Ms. Blair?
Aye.
Mr. Moore?
Aye.
Ms. Facey?
Aye.
Number 12, award contract to Minority Electric Company Incorporated, Lorain, Ohio, in the amount of $5,910 for emergency home repair assistance to Marie Schatzschneider, 46154 Butternut Ridge Road in New Russia Township, Ohio, for electrical repair. This is a community housing improvement program for fiscal year 2003 activity. Account number 22403-2601-450201.
So moved. Second.
Discussion? Ms. Facey?
Aye.
Ms. Blair?
Aye.
Mr. Moore?
Aye.
Number 13, award a contract to Dilly Door Company Incorporated, Defiance, Ohio, in the amount of $8,500 for emergency home repair assistance to Wayne Boylan, 43387 Oberlin Elyria Road in Carlisle Township, Ohio, for a foundation repair. This is a community housing improvement program, fiscal year 2003 activity. under account number 22403-2601-450201. The CHIP grant fund will pay up to $8,000, and Mr. Boylan has agreed to pay the remaining balance of $500.
So moved. Second.
Discussion. Ms. Facy?
Aye.
Ms. Blair?
Aye.
Mr. Moore?
Aye.
Under Engineer, number 14, authorize the clerk to forward to the Lorain County Auditor delinquent accounts on sanitary sewer charges according to the account listings provided by the Lorain County Sanitary Engineer in the various county sewer districts for collection on the tax duplicate for the year 2004, collection in the year 2005.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion. Ms. Blair?
Aye.
Mr. Moore?
Aye.
Ms. Facy?
Aye.
Number 15, authorize the Lorain County Auditor to levy special assessments for water line maintenance against all property within various county sewer districts, effective for the tax duplicate year 2004 and collectible in the year 2005.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion. Ms. Blair?
Aye.
Mr. Moore?
Aye.
Ms. Facy?
Aye.
Number 16, set up a public hearing date and authorize clerk to advertise for a public hearing for approval of engineer subdivision regulations file number 04-180.
So moved. Second.
Discussion. Ms. Facy?
Aye.
Ms. Blair?
Aye.
Mr. Moore?
Aye.
Number 17.
Commissioners, if I may, are we going to set up a date for that now, or are you just going to?
Would you like us to?
I think that probably would be a good idea.
Do we have to notify?
Yes, we have to advertise for 30 days before the hearing. I might also note that there are some issues, and I would suggest that the engineer's office be notified of that hearing and asked to attend the same. But yeah, I would recommend that we set up a specific date now.
Do you have a calendar, Janice?
I don't have one with me.
Here? So it would have to be like 45 days.
I would think that would be.
It would have to be sometime in October.
Do we want to do it on a Thursday? Is it?
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Thursday. Okay.
Do you anticipate much negative comment?
No, there just are some technical issues I think need to be discussed. And there might be some questions, so I think the engineer's office should be here.
Anybody else?
Probably Mr. Twine.
Oh, please.
October 14th, does that sound okay?
Okay.
14th of October.
And what time?
And how much time will we need?
10 o'clock, 10 a.m.
10 o'clock.
Commissioners, with your permission, I'd like to also send a notice to all the township clerks that this issue is going to be discussed then, so that we don't have somebody coming in at a late date saying we didn't inform them, because it's something that I believe directly influences what goes on out in the townships, and we've had some weak communication before, so I'll do that on behalf of the board to the clerk's
Sounds
office.
Sounds good. Okay. Thank you, Jerry.
Okay, number 17, set up a public hearing date and authorize clerk to advertise for a public hearing regarding a request for the removal of the paper street located in the Flint Ridge subdivision. Also set up a date to view paper street. This is a request from Richard Mongello that paper street should be removed to access Eagle's Nest Road to Durkee Road.
So moved.
Second.
Discussion.
You want to discuss, Mr. Griffin?
No, we need to set a date.
We need to set another date here.
I can arrange for transportation for the board as a whole on that date. I believe the board's required to view before they vacate, if they so choose.
Mm-hmm. Usually we go,
well, you can go
on a different day. We don't go on the day we take action.
If I might, Commissioners, I'm not, Teresa's been out this week, so I'm not We do have to notify the engineers department, get a list of adjacent landowners and notify them, so there's going to have to be some footwork done here. So I would suggest that the final hearing not, we give the final hearing a good 60 days before we reschedule that.
Do we have to schedule that today as well, or?
Yes, we have to set a date for viewing and a date for the final hearing. And then there's got to be some publications, and then there has to be notices to the individual landowners. We have to get a report from the engineer, and I'm not sure if Jack is familiar with this at all.
October 28th.
But we asked them to get us the names of all the abutting landowners and so forth, so that's probably going to.
You want to do the viewing?
Give them some lead time.
On October 28th?
On the public hearing, that's 60 days out.
Okay, when would you like to?
We can do that individually, or do we have to do that as a group?
You have to do it when the people are there, because people will come out, the neighbors.
As a group, they're supposed to do it, or they can't?
How about October 14th?
No, may I?
What?
Do you want to do it a week before?
What were you thinking?
Oh, no, I just say that afternoon. On Tuesday?
Yeah.
Which would be the 28th, 27th, 26th, October 26th?
Yeah.
October 26th.
October 26th for the public viewing.
And we need signs for both of those.
And 10 a.m. on October 28th for the hearing. Public viewing on a Tuesday would be, what's good?
10 a.m.
10 a.m.?
10 a.m.
Yeah, okay.
Are you traveling individually, Commissioner, or would you like to travel together?
We usually go with the engineer. I know Betty and I do.
That way we know where we're going.
And I don't have that issue as a man. I just go ask for directions later.
Oh, so easy. I can take it. I don't know.
No, you're actually blushing over that.
I know. I should have done that.
Even after 4 years.
I just lost a female vote had I ran. I don't usually blush, do I?
No, normally you don't. I'll make sure that the engineer has transportation available should you wish to avail yourself to.
For those who can't find it by themselves. There wasn't a motion on this, so.
Yeah, there was.
There was?
Yeah, there was, yeah.
We just had to put the times down.
Mr. Moore, and then you had seconded?
Oh, I was going to move again. Okay. So we got times?
Should we go ahead and take a vote?
Aye.
Or Mr. Moore? Ms. Blair?
Aye.
Ms. Vacy?
Aye.
Okay. Number 18, Solid Waste Management District. Approve additional funding for services provided by GT Environmental Incorporated, Westerville, Ohio, in an amount not to exceed $10,000 for additional solid waste management technical assistance, which will be dependent upon the district needs for the remainder of 2004. The district may require technical assistance on existing district program issues as well as assistance with other programs between now and the end of the year.
I think we approved a like amount last year also. Second.
Discussion. Ms. Blair?
Aye.
Ms. Vacy?
Aye.
Mr. Moore?
Aye.
Mr. Cordez, County Administrator?
Commissioners, I passed you some information early in the week, probably haven't gotten to it yet. The Department of Transportation has improved our environmental work over on the train station. Another hurdle has been overcome as we move that project forward. Also, our 106 historical review is now moved from the Department of Transportation to the state. It's on their desk, on their docket, they're working on it. So within the next few weeks, hopefully, I mean, they've been cutting staff and have budget issues down there too, we may have something back. I'm reporting this to you because the project has been inching along. We may be walking slow, but we're not walking backwards. So we have had some progress, and I have been in touch with Mr. Chesler this week to finalize some proposals to start turning our attention from the Justice Center and to the train station project. We still have a lot of work to do on phase four of the Justice Center, but it's not as time consuming as the building was, and we're going to be redirecting our energies. So you'll be hearing a lot more on the train station in the coming weeks, hopefully, as we want to progress on that project. We have the bids that are coming in today on the parking lots. I'm also telling you that because I anticipate quite a disruption in the downtown parking while we try to demolish the buildings on Second and Third Street. It's going to be significantly inconvenient to both the public and the employees, and we have to work through that issue too. So I anticipate quite a bit of discontentment in the coming weeks over the parking situation.
I doubt that. I don't see, because there's not that much parking there.
Well, the parking that we do have will be blocked off for the demolition. There's probably about 40 spots all in that are going to be affected over there.
But aren't they be moved over to the old courthouse?
Well, unfortunately, we brought people in from outlying areas, so the net gain was actually almost zero from the people we brought in from outlying areas, and then we created a little bit of additional public parking in the back. So we didn't really net that many parking spaces. It was a bit of a little bit of a relief, but I got to tell you, we're still strained until we get this project done. Once we get this project done, I think that we'll be able to alleviate the parking situation with regard to our needs in downtown Elyria for some time to come. But we're going to have to struggle through that. And lately, there's been a lot of problems with the parking. There's been some towing going on. A lot of it stems from our own county employees. And we've sent out a letter notifying all the people, all the elected officials, that we need their help to address that situation with where people should be parking and not parking. It got exacerbated when the Justice Center opened because we have a lot of people now walking a block or a block and a half to get to parking, and plus the Justice Center having only one access, and you have to come all the way around to the front of the building to get in, as people have started to not be happy with that situation also. So if you get the calls, please be patient, because we are trying to work through those issues. The record center is taking on additional records from all the departments that have moved over to the Justice Center, and things are going well there. If you have a chance, stop out, see what's going on out there. It's they're really growing at leaps and bounds out there. We met the other night in Oberlin. I've discussed briefly with one or two of you, but the Oberlin Township trustees have passed a resolution unanimously supporting the Oberlin Road Sewer Project. There's some caveats. Amherst Township Sewer Project. There's some things that we have to look at, but that'll be coming to you on the 23rd for decision. I hope to have information to you within the next week so that you have time to think about some of the issues that they're going to be putting on the table. Lastly, tomorrow at noon, there's a kickoff at Lorain Community College for the college partnership. They have a levy on the ballot this November. This is a very important issue for Lorain County, both for the economic growth and for the well-being of our residents here. If you have an opportunity, please come out. I'm on the levy committee for that. And I'm going to list information. I'm going to give you information, and I'm going to leave it here for people at the desk. We really need to continue the progress that's been made out at the Lorain Community College, and I would ask you to encourage you to take a look at that information and support that college this November. And thank you for your time and patience this morning.
Just as a point of information, you know, when you're talking about the transit, they own that the office space that they're in now.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe we should start real soon here getting an appraisal on what that is worth, and maybe putting it up for sale.
The current thinking, and I appreciate you bringing it up, we have a depletion schedule. FTA dollars were used to purchase the condo over at One Park Landing. It's quite a lengthy depletion schedule on that. If we were to sell it, we would have to reimburse FTA the vast bulk of the money that was obtained from the sale of the condo. I have spoken to the folks in Chicago, and they would be agreeable to allowing us to sell the condo, and if we were ready to move the people into the train station, the transportation center, and then move the depletion schedule from the condo to the transportation center, thereby keeping the FTA dollars,
mm-hmm.
Rather than having to reimburse them to FTA. But we have to be further along in the process. But I had similar thinking that you did. But if we moved them up to the admin building right now and we sold the condo, we would have, we would lose the ability to make that transfer, and therefore, we would lose the funding. So we have to wait just a little while longer, and maybe more than a little while, as the, maybe, you know, as the, another year or year and a half as we progress on the transportation center. But when that occurs, we'll be able to gain benefit of those resources to support this project.
Mr. Ennis?
No report.
Okay. Commissioners report?
Commissioner Vacy?
I have nothing.
Commissioner Moore?
None.
I have none.
Old business?
None here.
No.
I have none.
Okay. Any new business today?
Nope.
Okay. I would just like to share, in honor of the Justice Center grand opening, that the commissioners' offices in the administration building will be closed to regular business on September 2nd, while the offices located in the Justice Center will have limited access after 12:30 p.m. Also, there will be no board meeting that day. Board correspondence?
I move the reading be waived.
Second.
Discussion. Ms. Blair?
Aye.
Mr. Moore?
Aye.
Ms. Vacy?
Aye.
Any public comment today?
Anyone wishing to speak? Good morning, Elizabeth.
Good morning. Elizabeth Rummix, Oberlin. I have a question out of simple curiosity, as usual, and then a couple of comments. Number 12 on the agenda had to do with a CHIP program for almost $6,000, and I am simply curious, is this rewiring the entire house, or if I have to have rewiring or some work done in my house, am I going to have to plan for that amount of money?
Commissioners, that is exactly what this is. It's an old, I think it's a 60-amp fuse system in there, and under the CHIP program, we have to bring the electrical up to code. So they're putting a 200-amp fuse box in there. Now, Elizabeth in her particular house may have a 150-amp circuit breaker, but we have to go to 200 in order to accommodate the current electrical demands on a typical house. And so we're pulling everything out from the, basically, the meter can we're replacing inside that house. That's why, and we do pay prevailing wage, Davis-Bacon rates under this program. So those are the two items that typically escalate the cost. But this is a rewire.
Thank you, Mr. Twining.
Thank you. Then I'd like to mention that the flowers along the side of the administration building have been very, very attractive this year, thanks partly to Mother Nature and rain, no doubt, but also, obviously, there's been a lot of attention paid to them, and it really looks most attractive. I'd also like to say thank you for this new listing out, excuse me, Lorain County Administration Building and Justice Center locations, which is a nice listing of who is where and their actual phone numbers. And it's a very useful thing to have, I'm sure. So congratulations to whoever prepared that. Then my last thing is simply an announcement. I would like to say that in Oberlin this evening, we are having the 10th annual Women's Equality Day dinner with the theme, Not There Yet, Obstacles Women Still Face in Law, Business, etc., etc. But a special aspect of the evening is going to be presentation to Commissioner Vacy to honor her being the very first woman commissioner in Lorain County. And it promises to be a very nice evening.
Thank you, Elizabeth. Anyone else who wishes to address the board? I move we go into executive session for the purposes outlined by the administrator.
Second.
Awesome. Ms. Blair?
Aye.
Ms. Vacy?
Aye.
Mr. Moore?
Aye.
All right.
Unless otherwise announced, meetings are held Thursday mornings at 9:30 at the Lorain County Administration Building, 226 Middle Avenue, 4th floor, downtown Elyria. These are public meetings, and as always, you are invited to attend.